My name is Stephen Morgan.
I'm Ryan Brogan.
I'm Samantha.
And we're the team from Michigan State. Today we're presenting Farming into the Future with Ethanol, a strategic analysis of the Great Lakes Cooperative. So the Great Lakes Cooperative was formed through a merger of the Everly and Superior Cooperatives in Northwest Iowa, and today they actually serve over 2,300 farmers. And when we think about Great Lakes operations, it's served by two key pillars. The first is local access, and by this we mean local access to improved inputs, high-quality agronomic services, storage solutions, and also grain merchandising. And the second pillar is competitive returns, and by combining the access to all of these complementary services, they help farmers to access higher margins in grain markets.
This bundled set of complementary services is illustrated in this diagram by blue. The expansion of the ethanol industry has also opened up a new market channel, which the GLC Board of Directors is considering engaging through multiple options, including potentially direct contracting with ethanol producers, merger with ethanol producers, or even forward integration through the production of their own plants. Another important layer to this industry schematic is the intense level of competition on both input and output sides, combined with the freedom that GLC members have to transact with these competitors.
So before we make any recommendations on what strategy GLC should pursue, we're going to do a performance analysis to understand where is this company truly standing. We use four different measures, the first one of it being competitiveness. Because of the strategic geographic positioning of this cooperative, we believe that it has been able to keep the threat, of entrance to a limited position. Secondly, we believe customer satisfaction has actually increased in a period of 5 years by almost 5%, making it highly satisfactory to its members. Where we believe GLC Cooperative could actually improve are in the areas of productivity and profitability, as we see asset turnover and returns to asset decrease by 20% in a period of 5 years. With this, we take a leap into the SWOT analysis. The first pillar of this internal analysis is that of strengths. We believe that one of the great things of Great Lakes Cooperative is an ability to provide customized set bundle of services for its farmers and even non-members. And the democratic governance and ownership structure that allows participation of members and actual involvement in the decision-making process that makes this a great pillar in the core value chain in Iowa.
We also want to highlight a couple of key weaknesses. The first is that they're dependent on voluntary patronage for cooperative profits. This means that farmers actually don't have to sell their grain through the cooperative. And instead, oftentimes when there are higher spot market prices, farmers have an incentive to actually not sell to their own cooperative and to actually sell their grain on the spot market. The second weakness I want to highlight is the idea that there are multiple free rider problems in the structure. The first is that cooperative farmer members can actually potentially free ride on engaging in monitoring activities and management decisions within the cooperative, allowing other members to perform those functions. And they can also free ride off of the asset investments that other farmer members make.
Turning to some of the external forces shaping GLC strategic options, we want to highlight two opportunities. One is increased demand for corn and the opportunity for value addition of an otherwise undifferentiated commodity. Another opportunity is technological innovation in the form of petroleum-based farm inputs, which could stimulate local ethanol demand, as well as potentially reducing farm production costs. However, there are a few threats also to take into account. One is price and other uncertainties related to this new and rapidly changing industry. Other uncertainties include policy and behavioral. A final threat to highlight is the fact that biofuel plants often need to supplement local corn supply with additional food stocks from outside the region. Should these alternative food stocks become more competitive than corn, they could eat into corn profits or put at risk stakes that GLC has in the ethanol value chain.
Visualizing our SWOT analysis, we find that the strengths and the weakness are fairly well balanced with one another, but looking ahead, the threats slightly outweigh potential opportunities. And so given this analysis, we find that moving forward, GLC's best strategic directions are to either diversify current operations or actually exit the market.
So this takes us into the key strategic issue, in that the cooperative is to provide value to its members, and GLC is no different than that. And we we believe that we should answer how can GLC create more the maximum value for its members through involvement in this booming ethanol value chain in Iowa.
To answer this strategic question, we first want to respond to this critical question. What is the optimal governance structure that should coordinate corn supply with ethanol production? To help us, transaction cost theory specifies a range of governance structures. In a situation of low transaction costs, spot markets are the ideal governance structure. However, as transaction costs increase in a case, other governance structures become ideal, including hybrids such as different forms of contracting and alliances, all the way up to vertical integration in situations of high transaction costs. Transaction costs increase with asset specificity, uncertainty, transaction frequency, and complexity. In our assessment, this case exhibits high asset specificity due to the high plant value of ethanol production and combined with the high storage and transportation costs of corn, which imply site specificity. As mentioned, this case also exhibits high uncertainty.
We believe that this ethanol value chain exhibits high frequency of transactions, meaning that the ethanol plant has to run for a longer period of time and needs a constant supply of corn, which would mean a continuous operation and operation costs. With this, we take a leap into high complexity that comes with coordination and monitoring costs. All these four elements take us all the way to the right side of the spectrum into vertical integration as a key recommendation that we will suggest.
So building off of our transaction cost analysis, we've prepared two strategic alternatives for GLC to consider moving into the future.
The first alternative we consider is that of a new generation cooperative. With this in the transaction cost lingo, we would say this is the option to bake, and we would forward integrate into making our own, into the GLC making its own ethanol plant. With this, we will retain managerial control in the decision-making process and have constant involvement of farmers. Also, this provides the benefit that it would increase the value of ownership of the cooperative because they would make a significant investment that would generate income, not only right now, but to future generations of farmers in the cooperative. Some of the cons of this strategy is the limited experience of the board of directors in ethanol production and marketing and that of farmers as well. And the high capital requirements that would limit its ability to make the investment. And that also correlates with the idea of horizon costs that are common to that of cooperatives where short-term investments are preferred over long-term investments.
So the second strategic alternative would actually be more consistent with an exit strategy. And that's that the GLC actually accepts the Green Plains offer to acquire cooperative operations. And some of the benefits of this is that farmer members would be compensated with both cash and an equity package in exchange for their cooperative equity. They would then have access to potentially increased corn margins in the local area because the construction of a new ethanol plant would drive up local demand for source corn. They would also potentially provide the right incentives to have increased access to improved inputs. Ethanol production is optimized with certain varieties of corn and certain production practices, and Green Plains would have the incentives to provide these inputs through the cooperative outlets that they acquire. A couple of drawbacks is, first off, is there's a potential opportunity cost if farmers were to sell the cooperative now. Corn prices are in an upward trend at this point when this offer was made, and the cooperative could potentially be even more valuable a year down the road. And another problem that's important to highlight is if the farmers actually sell cooperative storage facilities to Green Plains, this could potentially touch off a private storage shortage, especially for farmers who don't want to sell their grain to Green Plains and to the ethanol plant. So when we're making this strategic decision about which of these alternatives GLC could pursue, we ask ourselves the question, which alternative best leverages GLC's core competency and minimizes transaction costs? So we've identified their core competency as their farmer-oriented supplier of corn inputs and merchandising services. And given that they have no experience in ethanol, this would suggest that they're being pushed towards option two. And finally, based on our transaction cost analysis, we believe that through vertical integration and consolidating all of these individual transactions within a single firm, this would minimize transaction costs.
Looking through this core competency and transaction cost lens, in the next few minutes, we want to highlight four reasons for which we believe that the GLC members should vote for the acquisition as opposed to forward integration?
First off, we believe this offer provides very strong value for owner equity. As we all are aware, markets for agricultural cooperative equity stakes are notoriously thin. And right now, farmers would have the potential to cash in their own equity that they've been holding. Also, GLC has not paid a patronage dividend in years. Many farmers have actually reported that it's been over 24 years since they've received a patronage dividend. So they actually haven't necessarily been receiving those payments on this equity stake. And then finally, by accepting this cash and equity offer, and the equities in the new Green Plains Corporation, this would allow farmers to potentially diversify their own investments to better fit their risk profile. For farmers who maybe don't want to be locked into corn production, they could use that capital to either purchase new technologies on their own or even engage in other production alternatives.
The second reason for an acquisition is that it could potentially minimize coordination costs by cutting out an unnecessary intermediary. The coordination between corn supply and ethanol production requires coordination in terms of delivery, volumes, timing, quality. This complexity can be managed through the network of elevators that the cooperative has. However, cooperative management of these elevators introduces another layer of transactions that could potentially be cut out.
We also believe this merger provides not only the capital, but the right incentives to invest in the structures to achieve higher margins. Right now, GLC is operating a no-reject policy on their grain elevators. So there's no monitoring of what farmers are actually delivering or the quality of grain. And so some reasons that an ethanol plant might discount what they receive from the cooperative elevators is high moisture content, low test weight, or high levels of damage.
So by shifting these costs to GPRE, the cooperative in itself is protecting its, from actual more spending and can actually result in a 5% premium paid for farmers for directly transacting with the ethanol plant. This takes us to the fourth reason on why should the cooperative merge with GLC GPRE. It is because it allows for the timely participation in the ethanol market. 62% of the corn acquired by ethanol plants comes directly from the transaction between the ethanol plant and the farmer. We also believe that the value of GLC is linked to that of corn prices, which fluctuates a lot and could result in a lower value in a future time period. With this in mind,
presuming that the GLC members vote for the acquisition, in these last few minutes, we'd just like to highlight three issues that they should consider going forward, and also recommend some mitigating measures to address, to manage the associated risks. First, GLC should immediately appoint a task force charged with managing and coordinating the cooperative's responsibilities and acquisition process, and to report on progress. Secondly, one of the first activities of this task force in the next 2 months should be to complete the due diligence process investigating GPRE as a company and the production plant to ensure that GPRE will be a successful business partner for the farmers. Finally, due to the important services that farmers derive from currently from the cooperative, combined with the potential market power they're handing over to GRP with an acquisition and ongoing uncertainties in this changing industry, we recommend the restructuring of GLC into a leaner bargaining association to continue to monitor market relationships and opportunities, as well as to negotiate and lobby for farmers when necessary. We also recommend consideration of inclusion in the acquisition agreements, the preservation of farmer access to private storage services in local elevators.
So finally, we have to ask ourselves, do these two pillars that we began our presentation with still stand in the absence of GLC? And the answer is yes. Farmers will still have local access to storage, to input services that they want, and to marketing of their corn, not only in the spot market and in what they want, but also in the ethanol production chain. And with that, that can potentially lead to higher, even higher competitive returns for them in the involvement of the ethanol production. Thank you so much for your time. This is not my real voice. I apologize. We would be happy to answer any questions.